Today, we'll prove what the derivative of inverse sine x is. An inverse function is an expression obtained by swapping x and y. So we can write x equals sine y from the equation y is inverse sine x. Taking the reciprocal of dy over dx and expressing it as 1 over dx dy, where dx over dy is simply differentiating x with respect to y, which becomes cosine y. Now, we can substitute this expression for dx dy into the equation we found, and dy over dx can be expressed as 1 over cosine y. To express y on the right-hand side of the equation as a function of x, we can utilize basic properties of trigonometric functions. We have sine y is x, and if we represent x as a fraction, it becomes x over 1. Visualizing this with a right triangle for sine y is x over 1, where y becomes an angle and the opposite side is x, and the hypotenuse is 1. Using the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of the adjacent side, we get square root 1 minus x squared. Now, let's find out how we can express cosine y, which we need, using this right triangle. Since cosine y is adjacent over hypotenuse, it becomes square root 1 minus x squared. Earlier, dy over dx was 1 over cosine y, so ultimately, dy over dx becomes 1 over square root 1 minus x squared. We've demonstrated the derivative of inverse sine x in a straightforward manner. Next, we'll show how to quickly and easily find the derivative of inverse sine x by slightly modifying this formula. Now, let's do something a bit unconventional and replace x with a box in our expression. We'll be finding dy over dx this time, and to do that, we'll make a use of the chain rule. If we substitute box with u, then y becomes inverse sine u. Using the chain rule to express dy over dx again, it can be written as dy over du times du over dx, where we need to find the values of dy over du inside the green box and du over dx inside the blue box. For convenience, let's label them as 1 and 2 respectively. To find dy over du, which is 1, we simply differentiate the previous expression with respect to u, utilizing our earlier result, 1 over square root 1 minus u squared. For du over dx, which is number 2, it is equal to d box over dx. Now, multiplying the result from 1 and 2, we get dy over dx is 1 over square root 1 minus u squared times d box over dx. If we represent d box over dx as a box prime and u as a box, it can be rewritten as 1 over square root 1 minus box squared times d box prime. This simplifies to box prime over square root 1 minus box squared. Now, we are well prepared to tackle more complex problems quickly and easily. Let's work through a simple example together. Here, we have inverse sine of 4x squared minus 7x. To find dy over dx, let's use the formula we derived earlier. Box prime over square root 1 minus box squared. What goes into the box? That's right, the expression inside the green box, which is 4x squared minus 7x. Now, let's substitute these terms into our formula. The derivative of the numerator 4x squared minus 7x is 8x minus 7, and the denominator remains square root 1 minus 4x squared minus 7x squared. That's it. Even though the problem may have seemed complex, we found the answer in just one line. Let's review the process we followed once more. The derivative of the inverse sine of box is box prime over square root 1 minus box squared. Now, if we integrate the right side, what should we get? That's correct, inverse sine of box plus c. With this in mind, let's solve one more simple example. Here, we have the integral of 1 over x times square root 1 minus ln x squared. Can you identify which term should be the box? If it's not clear, let's make a slight adjustment to the problem. What if we rewrite the expression as the integral of 1 over x over square root 1 minus ln x squared? Now, when you compare this to the previous yellow equation, it is evident that ln x goes into the box, and the numerator 1 over x is essentially the derivative of that box. So the answer is simply inverse sine of ln x plus c. If you like more diverse examples and detailed explanations, please click on the link in the upper right corner. There, you'll find videos explaining various problems in more detail. Today, we learned about the proof of the derivative of the inverse sine function and a quick method for finding its derivative. If you enjoyed today's video, please like and subscribe. Your support means a lot to me. Thank you to all of you who watched today, and I will see you again in the next video. Until then, this has been your math guardian, Alex.